Dear students, today we are going to read the story entitled Ishwar the Storyteller. Ninth class ka third chapter hai. First of all, I shall tell you the story. The main points of the story takes round, there are two main characters in the story, Mahender and Ishwar. Who was Mahender? Mahendra's job and his adjusting nature. Mahendra was an employee of a company and he had to live in outside areas mostly. His firm in which he employed built bridges, roads, etc. in the outside areas. That is why he had to live mostly in countryside, in the outside area, in forests. And his nature was very adjusting. He adjusted himself in every situation, whether he had to live in a big building or a tin roof shed. It doesn't matter much for him. Next are the cooking talent of Ishwaran. Ishwaran was a cook. He used to cook food for Mahendra. Wherever he went, Ishwaran accompanied him and he was a very good cook. He had a good cooking talent. He cooked very delicious food for Mahendra on different occasions. Next is Ishwar's art of storyteller. But there was a special quality in him. He was a good storyteller. He told stories to Mahendra and he used to tell stories in very artistic style. He described every tiny incident in a very artistic style that the listener he attracted listeners' attention towards his story because he had a good style. He was a good storyteller. The story of elephant that turned wild. So as it was his habit to tell new stories every day, every night, so one day he narrated the story of an elephant, that how a tusker escaped from a field and became wild, and how it entered a school ground and it ran here and there towards the children, the students closed themselves in the room, and at last how Ishwaran, the storyteller, was able to control the tusker. He wanted to tell the listener from this incident that he had a virtue to control the tusker, elephant. Next है ईश्वरन tried to control the elephant. इसमें आ ही गया ये कि how did, दोनों क्वेश्चन में दोनों मैंने आपको बताया कि how did a tusker escape from the field of its master and entered in school ground, and how did Ishwaran try to control the elephant, and ultimately Ishwaran controlled the elephant by hitting its toenail, because it is a particular method of controlling the elephants, the tusker. They are controlled by hitting their toenail. Next, leaving the story unfinished. It was his habit that Ishwaran, the storyteller, often his story remained unfinished, because he was a servant, he was a cook, and he had many other duties to do. And during those duties, he used to tell stories to the listeners, to Mahendra, who was his permanent listener. But often his story remained unfinished. And next day, on the next occasion, next day, he reminded, he was to remind, उसे याद दिलानी पड़ती थी that what was the point of the story, उसने कहाँ छोड़ा था स्टोरी को, ये उसको बताना पड़ता था. And he again began from the point. Next है Ishwaran's belief in supernatural things. At this point, there was much difference between the nature of Ishwaran and Mahendra. Ishwaran always believed in supernatural things. अलौकिक शक्तियों में विश्वास करता था, प्रेत आत्मा, भूत वगैरह, these are called supernatural things. And on the other hand, Mahendra did not believe in supernatural things. He always believed that these things are not existent. But one day it so happened, although he did not believe in supernatural things, but as Ishwaran, the storyteller, always mentioned supernatural things during his stories, and as a result of these kinds of stories, one day it so happened that Mahendra was sleeping at night in his room, and he listened a special kind of noise outside the window, First of all, he thought that it might be a cat or anything else. But when he looked outside, he saw a special kind of shape clutching a bundle under his arm, and he frightened of he shivered with fear he began to shiver with fear after seeing that shape, and as a result of that, after this incident, he resigned from his service and returned home. He did not, after this incident, he did not want to live in outside area where was his duty. He left the idea of living outside and he resigned from his post and returned home. तो प्रिय बच्चों, मैंने आपको ये स्टोरी बताई कि what kind of fellow ईश्वरन the storyteller was and how did he believe in supernatural things, and there was much difference between the nature of both the two characters of the story, and what happened with Mahendra, the listener of the story, in the end of the story. So you have to learn the story, you have to read the story from your book. It is very simple. And after that, you have to learn and write these questions in your notebook. थोड़ा हम भी कर लेते हैं इन क्वेश्चन के बारे में. फर्स्ट है कि इन व्हाट वे ईश्वर इज एन एसेट टू महिंद्रा. एसेट मीन्स हेल्पर. तो एज वी हैव रीड इन द स्टोरी दैट महिंद्रा वर्क्ड इन ए प्राइवेट फर्म. ही वॉज एन एम्प्लॉई ऑफ ए प्राइवेट फर्म, एंड इट वॉज हिज ड्यूटी टू सुपरवाइज द एक्टिविटीज ऑफ दैट फर्म इन द आउटसाइड एरिया, बिकॉज दिस फर्म यूज टू बिल्ड bridges and roads in the outside area of the towns and cities, and that is why he had to live in outside areas mostly. And Ishwaran was the only companion he always remained with him. He cooked food for Mahendra, and besides, he used to tell stories to entertain Mahendra to pass his time. So it is a fact that Ishwaran is a really a true helper, true asset to Mahendra. Next है, how did Ishwaran describe the uprooted tree? As we have read in this story, that Ishwaran has an art of telling the stories. Ishwaran was a good storyteller and used to tell stories in such an artistic manner that he made even tiny incidents very attractive. One day, Eastman described that one night he was going along a road and on the way he saw a frightened shape on the road and he shivered with fright. But at last, when he came nearer, then he came to know that it was nothing else but a tree which had fallen across the road. So Eastman described the uprooted tree, the incident of uprooted tree, in a very artistic manner to make it more attractive. How does Eastman narrate the story of a tusker? So we have read in the story that he used to tell stories and always on new topics. Sometimes he described uprooted tree, sometimes. So one day he narrated the story of a tusker, that how a tusker escaped from the field of his master and how he entered a school campus and how it frightened away all the students and teachers and it uprooted the football poles. Ultimately, Eastman, the storyteller, was able to control the tusker by hitting its toenail. He wanted to tell the listener by telling the story that he had a quality to control the tusker also by hitting the nail, their nail. He knew this art and he called this art of controlling the tusker a Japanese art. It was a Japanese art. ये जापानी कला थी तस्कर को कंट्रोल करने की, कि उसके टो को हिट करके उसको कंट्रोल किया जा सकता था. तो ही नरेटेड द स्टोरी ऑफ ए तस्कर विद द आर्टिस्टिक मैनर. नेक्स्ट है, व्हाई डिड द ऑथर से दैट ईश्वरन सीम टू मोर देन मेक अप फॉर द एब्सेंस ऑफ ए टीवी इन महिंद्रास लिविंग क्वार्टर. So we have read in the story again and again that Mahindra had to live in outside areas mostly because it was function of his firm to build bridges and roads in outside areas. Mostly he had to live alone, and as Eastman was with him, he always entertained him with his stories. As Mahindra had no TV for entertainment in his room, in his living, in his quarter, आवास accommodation, जहाँ भी वो रहता था वहाँ TV वगैरह की कोई व्यवस्था नहीं थी. But he needed no TV because Eastman seemed to more than make up for the absence of TV in Mahindra's living quarter. He completed that deficiency, वो कमी पूर्ति कर देता था. टीवी की जरूरत ही नहीं थी. तो प्रिय बच्चों, आज मैंने आपको थर्ड स्टोरी आपकी बुक मोमेंट्स की बताई. ऑलरेडी आई हैव टॉट यू टू स्टोरीज एंड आई होप दैट यू हैव लर्नड एंड रिटन द क्वेश्चन आंसर ऑफ दोज टू चैप्टर्स ऑल्सो एंड आई होप दैट यू विल राइट एंड लर्न दीज फोर क्वेश्चंस दीज फोर आंसर्स ऑफ दीज फोर क्वेश्चंस आफ्टर रीडिंग दिस स्टोरी. जैसा समय है, जैसी परिस्थितियाँ हैं, वी हैव टू प्रोसीड अकॉर्डिंग टू टाइम विच इज़ गोइंग ऑन नाउ एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू सरकमस्टांसेस विच वी आर फेसिंग नाउ. जैसा समय, जैसी परिस्थितियों से देश और हम भी फेस कर रहे हैं, सामना कर रहे हैं, उनका मुकाबला करते हुए हमें आगे बढ़ना है. एंड वी हैव टू कंटिन्यू अवर स्टडी. इसलिए मेरा आप सभी से बार बार यही आग्रह है. एंड आई होप दैट यू यूटिलाइज योर टाइम फुल्ली. यू ऑलवेज रिमेन योर स्टडी रूम एंड यू लर्न योर लेसन peacefully and perfectly. Thank you very much.